have this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to stop the cane toad invasion just south of Broome. To do that, we'll be creating a toad containment zone, which is a waterless barrier that will act like a firebreak to stop toads. And that will be delivered by a coalition of the willing, which consists of the traditional owner groups, and Nyangamata and Gurradjeri, as well as the local pastoralists in the region. And this funding that has been provided by the state government is a really important first step for us to engage with that community and bring them together and facilitate them moving forward with this project and delivering this nationally significant conservation initiative. Cane toads come in huge numbers, so you get thousands of cane toads around water points. These are the same water points that are being used by our native species. Many of those native species, particularly predators, will show rapid population declines when cane toads arrive. So things like northern quolls and floodplain monitors in particular more or less vanish from the landscape with the arrival of toads. By implementing the toad containment zone, we keep them out of a huge area of the country, and that completely prevents the impact that toads will have on those species in those areas. So there's this narrow coastal strip that toads need to move through if they're to make it to the Pilbara. The plan is to create a break in that strip by upgrading pastoral infrastructure such that the water of it is not available to toads. Upgrading that pastoral infrastructure, maintaining it and monitoring it will be a partnership delivered by pastoralists, but also with the monitoring delivered by the Indigenous ranger groups, Nyangamata and Gurradjeri, whose country it is that we'll be working on.